Hey, welcome to Laura's Bane and Minis. I am Laura. Let's get baning. We're getting really close to finishing these guys up. Let's see how doing this semi-quickly works out. I don't want to end up taking forever to get these things done. Because I want to get them sold. Get them done so I can sell them. Just gonna do try and quick lock some things in. Get it looking nice. See how long that takes. Or decent anyway. So both of that armor to do on each of these guys. At the same time, I also have been really excited to get a chance to do these axes. So I don't want to go too fast. Be a lot of time to enjoy the process. like a map. They're sketched out. Probably won't talk as much as other streams. It does take a lot of focus doing NMM. Especially when I'm trying to do this kind of like trying to do quicker than I have. And that's good. A good start for doing this kind of quickly. It's looking shiny. Shadow than the other side. He's got it tilted to one side. So, won't necessarily go up to white on this side. And the little ones that you can still see those rivets. Okay. That looks pretty cool. This is probably gonna be the most difficult part. One of these minis. Because it's a rounded surface. I have done it before, so that's why I'm getting to a decent looking blend placement already. It's the very first time I decided to try out an NMM, a gold NMM recipe was on any that had a helmet actually. I don't know why this doesn't want to focus any better. Oh, that's a little better. Stop tearing off one of my colors because it's getting dried out and also a little bit on the dark side. It's a little bit better blend. Okay. It's not speed painting by any means, but looks pretty decent. Sorry, I haven't been as chatty. Like I said at the beginning, it takes a lot more focus doing anime, especially when I'm trying to do it really quick. So I have a good start, at least with that, and it definitely on the axe especially, sorry, I could definitely tighten that up. I think I got away from doing faster and started going back to my slower, smoother blends when I got to the pauldron, because it's just harder in general doing that pauldron. I think that's the right word. Because it's rounded. It's flat surfaces here. Complicates things a little bit. And you'll have that, that will be there a little bit when I do these, because they are going to be a little bit rounded. But not really as badly as this. So, yep. I know it didn't even get one whole orc done with all the NMM on it, but I feel pretty good about where I did get. Getting these two done, they're the biggest spots on these minis. As far as the NMM goes, a lot of other things, they're smaller buckles or studs. These pieces are a lot more shadow, which is not very big. The knife, again, is not very big. So, those will go. I imagine I can probably get all of the rest of the NMM on this one done in just about the same, not less time as it took me to do this pauldron and the axe. We'll see. I'll definitely be moving on to a different mini for next week's Twitch stream. I do want to. I am going to get these done. But I want to move on for Twitch streams. I've been doing these minis a lot. Feel like for those of you watching, it's going to get pretty boring. So, I have minis out actually, so I can show you what the next minis will be. It's going to be another grouping. These are, and it's more next level minis from their first Kickstarter. Bunch of moles. Fits like something like that. Little shield. Trying to think if they're all the same or not. Yeah, well, yeah, never mind. Yes, they're all the same. That's how they did their groupings, as everyone has same exact pose and equipment. I still need to clean these. This is not part of it. Just a little bit of a some flashing comes off, just like that. Yeah, these will be some fun gnolls to paint. I think. Done. Pretty cool mace. Or, not mace. I always want to call these mace. Flail. Technically, I think, because it's got a chain. That's another flashing. This print has quite a bit of armor on these guys too, but I might see if some of my metallic. I was gonna try and see about my metallic paint on the orcs, and I really just didn't like how metallic that I did have was looking on it, and I think, honestly, a lot of my metallics are probably have gone bad. I haven't used them or shaken them up in a very long time. So, yeah. So, anyway, yep. There's that work. Cool. I'll let you know next week if I've got them up. I mean, up for sale on eBay. If you check out my Facebook and Insta, you'll get an update as soon as I do list them on eBay for sale. So I'll put the link there in those. Yeah, and Facebook, my Facebook and Insta. If there's anything that you're interested in contacting me about painting, feel free to message me on any of those things, Facebook, Instagram. I do have Fiverr as well, under Laura Limbrigle or L Riggle, and I've got 3 gigs up and running basically for each 3 of the typical sizes of minis. So give those a look. Maybe it'll fit under what you're wanting me to do, or you can message me there too, and we can create something custom for you. If it is something that I think that I can do. Yeah, and I just started doing exclusive focus tutorials on my Patreon, and that's under Laura's Painted Minis as well. That'll be for sure, at least once a month, it will be a video, and then I am going to be working on doing a write-up that will be kind of a companion to the video. And those who subscribe to the first tier will get that PDF, and then if you want the videos, it'd be the tiers, you'll want to upgrade your tier. For your subscription. But yeah, that's it for tonight. I'll go ahead and put my socials into chat. That way you can easily just pick whichever one you want to contact me through or subscribe and click on that link. So hope you have a good weekend. I will see you next week. Bye.